So the final release version of Windows 11 is officially out now, so we are going to check out how you can upgrade from Windows 10 without waiting for the update to be rolled out for your device. So the first step would be obviously to check out if the update is available for you, and to do that, you will have to go to the Settings app and click on Updates. If it is available, then you just have to click on it, but if the update is not available, you will have to go to this page on Microsoft's website, which I will link to in the video description, and here you will find three options to upgrade. Now the two options below will require you to install it from a pen drive, which is a more complicated process, so the easiest option will be by downloading the Windows 11 Installation Assistant. After clicking the download button and opening it, you will see this screen if you have a Windows 11 compatible PC. Any recently purchased PC within 3-4 years should be compatible, but you may also need to enable TPM, UEFI, and secure boot manually in your device's BIOS settings, so I will link to some articles that explain how to do that in the description. So now once you can go ahead and click on install, Windows 11 will get downloaded, and after that, it will start getting installed right away. And this process can take around 20-30 minutes. After this gets finished, the PC will get restarted, and then all you have to do is wait for the installation to complete, and when it finishes, you will be greeted by the sweet welcome screen of Windows 11. This mostly seems to be just a redesign, which is very similar to Windows 10 underneath, so you shouldn't really need to do a fresh install, and you can just upgrade your existing Windows 10 installation. But I am still liking this a lot so far, because everything feels fresh and modern with nice animations, and all of this does affect how you feel while interacting with the OS, so even though there are some missing features on Windows 11, I do think that the benefits outweigh the few missing things that should get added over time. And that will be it for this video. Let me know if you're enjoying Windows 11 in the comments. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and I'll see you in the next one.